morning and welcome to Late Night Bride. We're so glad you're here. Tonight we're going to talk about something that's incredibly important on your wedding day, photography and videography. Now one is a photo, but one is film, and they're two very different mediums, but together they form an amazing marriage that photographs and tells the story of your day. We love to say every picture tells a story. And tonight we're going to talk with the top professionals in their fields about photo and film, and most of all, about you. So sit back, relax, get a cup of tea, and together, let's do Late Night Bride. Late Night Bride, and we're going to talk about photography. Every picture tells a story, and here's an amazing couple that tell the best story. I want to introduce to you Mickey and Sonia, photography.
Thank you.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
You were the very first photography team that I ever met in the industry 11 years ago, and it was a referral. It was referral, you said. Mm-hmm. And because I was getting married, and photography was just such an important piece of my day, or actually our day, because it isn't my day, it's our day. And to have a couple shoot it was so important. Tell me how you met. Tell me a little bit, tell everyone about you, because photography is such about relationship, and it's your relationship, I know, that absolutely captured my heart and really made it important that we work together. Mm-hmm. So tell me, how did you meet?
So we actually met at photography school. So there's been a lot of photography going on for a lot of time.
Yeah, I came to this country to study photography. I went to Brooks Institute of Photography in Santa Barbara.
Right.
And that's how I met Sonia. She was a student there. We did a lot of assignments together, and we realized that we can really work well together and
as a team.
As a team.
And we've been doing that ever since.
Yeah. And how long have you been shooting together?
We've been shooting weddings for 17 years.
17 years.
Yeah.
Now here's the secret. You're also married.
Yes, we are.
And we've been married for 17 years.
17 years.
So was the I do first before the partnership? Or the partnership and then I do just naturally fell in?
We were both shooting separately before we got married, but then as soon as we were married, we officially combined
absolutely
businesses, and we've been doing it together.
Yep. Yeah. And there is male and female perspective,
You
know, so that's why we shoot together. She sees things a little differently than I, but when we blend those things together, you know, we really tell full story.
So. And that's really important. It really is important because, you know, in each day, there are different elements. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you're with the ladies and you're with the gents and the ladies. Because even with you know, having the girls, I know you're still there because you have a certain eye, you know, you're shooting the detail shots. Talk a little bit about that piece of the day, because that is where the setup starts. Mm-hmm. Talk about the detail shots.
Well, I feel like it's really important for Mickey and I to do the detail shots together. So we'll both go to the bride's room, and we'll kind of help each other get everything set up.
Right.
And then while one of us is actually photographing the details, the other one can be getting the candids in the room.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then once those details are finished, then he goes off with the guys and I get to stay with the girls.
Yay.
And it's a lot of fun.
Now, when we talk about details, because I think sometimes what happens is we talk in our vocabulary. Mm-hmm. So let's kind of share what the details are.
So there are a lot of details now because everybody sees everything like on Instagram or Pinterest. Mm-hmm. So it's the setting up of the dress. It's the photographing of the shoes, the invitation suite, the rings, you name it. Bouquets, boutonnieres.
Bouquets, right. Yeah. Now it's the girls in the robes.
The girls in the robes.
Is that like the trend shot?
It is.
Yeah.
And it sounds like an easy shot, but it's not necessarily so easy because everybody has to have their hair and makeup done at the same time.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, and it's usually right before the bride gets dressed. So the timing is really important
for that shot. Very important.
So let's talk about timing because I know, you know, as the planner and as the photographer, you know, we're timed. I mean, it literally is moment by moment, shot by shot.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, when a bridal couple comes to you and says, I want all of these pictures, you say?
Then you need to talk to the coordinator because we need extra time.
Okay.
We need time for photos.
Of the different groupings, getting ready, portraits, ceremony, reception, where do you see people being slightly, I can't say unrealistic, but wanting more?
That's tough. So many thoughts go into each part of the day that each part of the day is so important to the couple.
Yeah.
And we want to make sure that we get it all.
As you mentioned, time is everything, and timing is everything too. So my advice always to a bride is please don't be late.
Right. So I guess specifically we lose most of the time during portraits.
Portraits. Right.
Yeah.
What's your favorite shot?
Ooh.
There's a lot.
Every wedding has a favorite shot.
Well, I mean, because you see it differently from person to person.
Yeah.
You know, do you, like for me, I love the groom. I mean, I love that moment. The first time he sees his bride coming down the aisle, and I literally watch his heart open and just everything of pure joy.
Those emotional moments are the best to capture. Absolutely.
Yeah, and every wedding has them, you know.
If you could give two top tips to the couples that are listening, what would they be?
Timing is everything.
Yeah.
So just making sure that your timeline is realistic, that you have enough time to get what you actually need.
Right.
Especially from photography, because it takes a while to get the important shots.
Yeah.
Right.
Tip number two.
Mickey, what's your favorite tip?
Just please don't be late.
Timing.
Timing, because it throws everything.
Absolutely.
You know, because we can speed up stuff, but, you know, it is very important because that's how your day start, you know.
Right.
Dinner will not start later because, you know, it has to be on time. The only time that you can catch up is the time for photos. And it is very, very important because really after the wedding, photos are what you're going to have, and video.
And so, speaking of time, we're going to come right back because we have a lot more to share. We're going to talk about video for a bit, and then we're going to have the conversation together because it really is a marriage between video and photography. So we'll be right back with Late Night Bride.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Late Night Bride. And I know you want to know who just shot all that fabulous film. So it is with great honor and a privilege to have Mr. John Goolsbee, who is truly the godfather of film. Godfather Films, you rock.
Thank you very much.
And we were chatting while the film was running because we get to do that. And you were telling me literally point by point, I was here, this was that, this was this, this was that. Tell a little bit about the actual backstory on that reel.
I've been able to film over 3,000 weddings, 25 different countries, 32 different states, and it seems like they're all still in my head. I still remember all the details, still keep in contact with a lot of these brides and everything. Oh. There was a bride who walked down the aisle with a Black Panther.
Right.
And the discussion with the event planner was, should I do a Black Panther or an ice sculpture? She was actually debating between the two. She went with the Black Panther. She thought
people would remember.
The wedding in Puerto Rico where they partied till 2 in the morning, sat by the pool till the sun came up, wanted to do something special, and jumped in the pool with her dress still on. And we had a camera underneath and all that. When she got out of the pool, she wasn't wearing her dress anymore. She was wearing his shirt, which was pretty cool. And then Lennon Hills in Moscow. They went up there and shot off fireworks and toasted champagne. I am so lucky to have this career where I get to experience. We all love a good story.
Right.
And at every wedding, you've got all the elements of a good story. You've got the romance, you've got the drama, you've got the comedy, you've got the suspense. For me as a filmmaker, going to a wedding is like being in a movie, 3D, and it's all happening around you.
And it's all in real time.
I love that.
It's all in real time. People don't understand that.
So we have commercial filmmakers here today doing the show, and I've had a lot of my commercial filmmakers come out and film weddings.
Right.
And working in a one-take environment is not for everybody.
Nope.
There is a certain pressure that's on, but I like it.
And we don't get to say, you know, when we're out there, it's live theater. It's scripted. We have a timeline. But sometimes we have to go off that because something happens that you have to capture.
Yeah.
And you really are the voice of it. You know, we're talking with Mickey and Sonia earlier, and we're all going to talk together here in a minute about the marriage between photography and videography. And you said something that was absolutely perfect. Say it again.
Oh, it's the type of marriage where you sleep in separate beds.
And why is that?
Well, early in my career, I was starting out, and there really wasn't any place to go for education. So I would just follow the photographer.
Right.
And one day a photographer talked to me as I was filming what he was shooting, saying, is this good video? And while he wasn't saying it to be nice, I took it to heart. I'm saying, what could I do to make it better? So the very next wedding I go to, when the photographers are posing the girls,
right,
I'm hanging out with the guys. They're making jokes about who the best man is and studs in their shirt, and they got alcohol in their flask in their coat. And it's just so entertaining. It's all just happening. I'm not staging it. I'm not posing. It's just happening. And then the photographer came into the guys to pose them, and they all like settled down and calmed down. I went and hung out with the bride and her mother and the girls. And there's this nonverbal communication that takes place on the wedding day between a bride and her mother that you can't stage.
No.
You can't make happen.
Mm-mm.
But it happens.
Right.
And I absolutely love that.
And you really film, because it's constant, really, really, really brings in the emotion of what's going on. And I don't know anybody who captures it better than you, because you are so aware. You are so aware. Part of it, I'm sure, is the amount of time you've been in the business, because you've been here with us for a very long time. But I think it's truly your heart that you bring every single time. It's, you're fresh, you're aware. And, you know, for me, you know, you're a joy to work with. And we've shot a few together, not as many as I'd like, but there's still time where we're, neither one of us are retiring, I mean, I know. But what are some, you know, when you're working with a couple, what are some tips that you would really like for them to know, especially about video?
Before I forget, I always tell my kids the ultimate goal in life is to be old and in love.
Right.
And the path to that starts with the marriage commitment. And every wedding I've ever filmed, I can look at the groom as the bride's walking down the aisle, and there's a awareness in his face of how lucky he really is to be taking this step. Every time I hear a bride say her wedding vows, I can hear her grow more in love. on that wedding day, all the important people are at one place at one time to see a couple happy. The bride and groom only get to experience 10% of this event they spent time planning, and we only remember 10% of what we experience. So the day after a couple's wedding, they only have 1% in their mind of this big event in their life, and the challenge is all memories fade and most eventually disappear. I'm John with Godfather Films, and I sell time travel.
Now that's a great way to do it. And that's how I present it too, in the sense that the bride does not see anything prior to stepping out and going down the aisle. She doesn't see the guest arrival. She doesn't see the getting ready of the venue and the ceremony and the florist and all of the fun, literally from nothing to this magnificent vision that is totally hers.
People have to tell her how cute the flower girl and ring bearer were.
I know.
And who's gonna walk her down the aisle?
And who's gonna walk her down the aisle?
Dad, he's been thinking about that walk since the first time he held her. He doesn't get to see that walk. A lot of times when couples come to see me and they're thinking about wedding video because they're still on the fence about it, because they're really like the first generation to really have the opportunities they have now. And they'll say, well, I'm not sure I'm really going to watch it that much. And I want to say, well, it's not just for you.
Right.
You had grandparents who had grandparents. You never got to meet them. You never got to hear their voice. But what if you could?
Right.
What if you could put in a film of their wedding day and hear your great-grandpa telling a funny joke and see all the people are there laughing and crying? That would be amazing. Well, most of us are going to have grandchildren that have grandchildren, and we are the first generation to have this unique opportunity to give them time travel to the people they descended from. We used to live in caves, our early ancestors, and they used to draw on the cave walls. I don't think they were just drawing art. I think they were drawing memories of their adventures, celebrations, and the people they love. And then they started putting it on a rock so they could take it to the next village and show it to them. And then on animal skin, then canvas, then photography, then video. A lot of times I'll hold up an iPhone and play video. It's the new rock. We're still doing the same thing. We're still sharing the stories. We just have more ways to do it now.
It's perfect. Well, we're going to share more stories in just a minute, because we're going to bring both photography and videography together in one conversation, because we all work together as one. And we're going to tell an amazing story through pictures. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Late Night Bride, where we're talking about film and photo. These three lovely people just do an amazing job together. And I'm really gonna have them talk, because you don't need to hear it from me, you need to hear it from them, about how they work together. Because yes, it's a marriage, but as John said, they sleep in separate beds. And that's probably the best metaphor I have ever heard for this relationship. And it is a relationship. So the ladies are gonna start first, John. So, when you're working with videography, share, you know, how best does it work?
I think as long as we communicate, then everything goes really smooth. And we're respectful of each other. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Watching where we can each go to get our shots. You know, getting out of each other's way if necessary.
And John, when you're working with photography?
Well, I've got to agree. It's a respect for all the vendors. And I have this mindset that our clients and their guests assume that all of the vendors have met, collaborated, and we're all on the same team. With that mindset, we have to decide if we're going to be a good team or a bad team.
Right.
I'd much rather be a good team. I produce a better product. I hope the other vendors produce a better product because of my concern for what they're doing. One thing I always say to photographers when we arrive at the day is, do whatever you need to do to get a shot. You know, I had three children that got married, and we got really good photographers, and I'm glad I did. I don't want the photographer to lose one image because of something I'm doing. But I've been doing it long enough, I'm gonna get the shot. I carry my camera on a monopod a lot, and it's like a 7-foot pole if I extend it, so I can get 15 feet in the air. I had this photographer, she was about 5'2", and she comes up, she says, oh, let me know if I get in your way. I'm 6'3". I'm not worried, you know?
We're all good here. We're all good here.
And so I want everybody to do what they need to do to deliver their job. I have the advantage of being much more mobile.
Right.
And I don't pose anybody. I don't interact with anybody. And when the photographer is doing like their formal posing, it's really not that exciting video. So I'll go find something else to film.
Yeah.
Yeah, mm-hmm. You're right.
So, excuse me, let's talk some fun stories. You know, the moment, the shot that you got that you didn't know you were going to get, that story. Ever have one of those because I know I've watched you shoot, and you're so clear about where you're going to be, and but yet you're fluid with it too, because you, as much as we think we know it's going to go a certain way, sometimes it doesn't, and there's a magical shot that happens that you couldn't have created, you know, on your own. You know, the one that you look back on now and go, wow, that was amazing. I can't believe I got it.
Reflections.
I'm thinking.
You see, there is a reason why we always shoot together, because it's not like two of us standing next to each other taking the same shot. You know, if I find a good angle, I guarantee you that Sonia is going to try to get better angle than me. There is a little competition between us going on. And because of that approach, sometimes, you know, I miss shot because somebody literally just walk in front of me or pull the cell phone out, you know, when Bride was walking down the aisle. But I guarantee you, Sonia was on the other side from a different angle, and she was be able to get a shot.
You said something very important, and I'm going to jump on that. Cell phones. I see it all the time, and even though the officiant, the rabbi, whoever is doing the ceremony, even though they say please don't, people still do. Mm-hmm. And it's about respect. You know, A, they've hired you to do a job, but also if they're shooting, they're not present in the celebration. They're not listening. They're not feeling what's going on. And you can, you know, speak to this one too, because you know, I'm sure you pan the crowd and it's like, hello, everybody's, you know.
That doesn't bother me at all. There is something I do that I think makes photography and video a little different, and I think my video is worth more because I do want it to be different than the photography.
Right.
I know the photographer needs images of people looking spectacular and all that, and I'm not too worried about that because they've got it covered. I'm looking for how they feel. With the bride, when she puts her dress on and she turns and she's taken in the mirror by her own beauty, I love that. Or when the bride's walking down the aisle and everybody is looking at the bride except for one person. Mm-hmm. The mother of the groom is looking at her son. And there's this emotion that's coming over her face that you can't stage, you can't get. So I'm always thinking about the things that are different than photography, because if all I do is duplicate what the photographers are doing,
right,
I'm not reaching my potential or giving the best advantage to the client.
Mm-hmm. So if I'm hearing you correctly, and I truly believe this, is that photography without video is half a marriage.
Peanut butter without jelly.
Okay. All right. Salt without pepper.
Yes.
Cream without sugar. Uh-huh. We're going to go for all of them on that. And I'm sure you feel the same way too, is that, uh-huh, you know, when we all come together, it truly is telling a story. And it's a story that they're not going to see until they see your video, and they're not going to see until they see, uh-huh, your photograph. Yeah. If they're truly in it, then it is your jobs as a team to really capture the love that is in their hearts and in the hearts of everyone that's there.
It's easier to work together than not to work together.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And photographers, as a photographer, I cannot record a sound. That's,
and he gets that.
The sound.
He gets, mm-hmm, that.
I know for me, I wouldn't do a wedding without you. Whether it's video or photography, whether it's Mickey and Sonia or John Goolsbee, Godfather Films, Mickey and Sonia Photography, they're the best that I know. You're the one I call first. You're the call I always make. And you know, we want our audience to really know how to get in touch with you. So tell them your social media and how they can reach you.
through our website, which is MickeyandSonia.com, or they can see more images on Instagram.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And John?
Everything's Godfather Films for me. The Instagram, the Facebook, the website, GodfatherFilms.com.
Okay. If you could say one word, what would it be? About what you do.
Oh, passionate.
Okay. John? She stole your words?
Selfish. I think a bride should do it her way, regardless of what anybody's telling her. It's that one moment where you get to express your individualism and your commitment for each other. So regardless of what the tradition is, if you want to do something, do it. But tell your photographer and videographer.
Absolutely.
Yes.
So from our hearts to yours, thank you for joining us tonight on Late Night Bride. Join us every night, either on Facebook at latenightbride.com, latenightbride.com at Facebook. But know that we're here for you. We're a community that stays up late so that you don't have to. Our whole mission is to get you offline and back into your engagement by having great resources that will tell you the truth about what's going on, what you need, what you don't need, but most of all, to love you through your wedding planning process. So for tonight, thank you from Late Night Bride, John Goolsbee, Mickey and Sonia Photography. It's Late Night Bride.